Hey everybody, thanks for tuning in. I'm Zach Peterson, I'm a technical consultant with Altium, and today we're gonna look at a little demo with what you should put in your silkscreen layers in your components versus your PCB. Now, in a previous video, we introduced silkscreen just as far as like where it goes on the PCB. Obviously, it has its dedicated layer, but where it goes on the PCB versus where it goes on the component. What information should be put in each of those layers? So today what we're gonna do is we're gonna go over a quick demo in Circuit Maker. And if you haven't downloaded Circuit Maker yet, or you wanna follow along, go download it. It's free to download, free to set it up, free to install and create your Altium 365 account and everything else you need to get started. So I'll give you a little demo as far as how to create the component, what information to put in the silkscreen layer in the component versus what information you should put in your silkscreen layer in your PCB layout. Let's get started. Okay, everybody. If you're gonna follow along with this little demo, just open up your copy of Circuit Maker. You could do the same in any other program, but I'm gonna show this in Circuit Maker just because it's super easy to do this demo in Circuit Maker. And you can go and download your own copy of Circuit Maker for free, set up your personal workspace on Altium 365, and then you can go through all the steps that I'm gonna show here. So really quick, we wanna go over what goes into your PCB layout in terms of the silkscreen, and then what goes into the components. You need to include different pieces of information in each of these areas. So here I've got a blank PCB layout, and I'm just gonna open up the Libraries tab here in Circuit Maker. And really quick way to just go in and create a new component, toss some random text in here, hit enter. Obviously nothing's gonna come up, and then just create custom part. So here we wanna create a new part. And here I'm just gonna go over the footprint because we're talking about silkscreen and what needs to go in your footprint versus your layout. So real quick, let's look at the footprint. And in this demo, we're gonna just find a new part real quick. So I'll go over how to quickly find a new part. So I'm gonna go over to Octopart, SMD, here we go. So we'll look for a SMD MOSFET. So I'm on Octopart going through some search results. I don't know, this one looks as good as any. And then let's go into the data sheet. Failed to load PDF, let's see. Okay, cool. So here we are. We're in the data sheet. And what we want to look for is, let's just keep scrolling. Here we go. Soldering footprint. They won't always call this PCB footprint in a data sheet. Sometimes they'll call it the soldering footprint. Sometimes they'll say recommended land pattern, something like this. But yeah, you just need to look for this. Be careful because this is not always placed in every data sheet. Sometimes what they will just do is show just the outline, and you can't just design to the outline here, because if you design the pads to match this outline area right here on this pin, let me zoom in on this pin, there won't be enough room to form a nice solder fillet on the edge of the pin, and you won't be able to solder the components correctly to the pads. So this is the info that we want to use. And I'm gonna do this in inches so I can see my pads are 24 mils wide, 60 mils tall. So to do this, I'm just gonna place a pad. There we go, let me click on it. So this is pin one. So this is the important pin to start out with. One of these two pins in the lower left or upper right corner is going to be pin one. And you can always tell just by scrolling up, scroll up to the top here, and you can see right here on the pinout, they've got pin one marked right here in this point. Obviously, if you take this component and rotate it 180 degrees, pin one would be on the upper right. So I'll just do it on the lower left just for simplicity. So let's come back down here and okay, so 24 mils wide, 60 mils tall. So here when you place the pad, you just need to be careful, and this isn't just a Circuit Maker thing, it's for any CAD software. Usually what they'll do is they'll place a pad and it'll have a hole in it, so by default it's a through-hole component. Just change that hole size to zero if this is gonna be SMD. Then we want a rectangular, hold on, rectangular component. My X is 24, 60 is already the default, and that's what it was set previously, so that's good. Okay, so that's our pin one pad. And generally when you have them nicely arranged like this, you can just copy them over, you know, copy over 2, 3, and 4. And so I'll do that now. And then if you see here in the data sheet, they're separated. So pin pitch is 50 mils. So it's nice about matching your grid size to your to the distance that's in the data sheet, is that you can just really quickly copy this and move it over. So each one of these squares here is 5 mils. So I need to know I need to go over 25, 50 in order to make a copy of this pad. So we'll just select it on the center, paste it over number 2, and then you can select them both, copy it, paste it over. Okay, and that'll be pins 3 and 4. Pretty simple. So we can do the same thing for the rest of the pins. 5, 6, 7, and 8 will be over here. And I won't go through that whole thing just because I want to kind of get to the important point, which is the silk screen. So here with this component, what you would want to do is a couple things. First, we want to put an indicator here for pin one. So our pin one indicator tells the assembler, hey assembler, this is where the component needs to sit and where it needs to be located. Or where it needs to be rotated, excuse me. So the pin one designator will be placed using, hold on just a moment. Oh, here we go, full circle. So this is what you want to use to place a pin designator. And you would just put it somewhere in this area. You want to make sure that you don't violate any clearance rules with respect to silkscreen and its distance from the solder mask opening or from the pad. The issue is that it's just one of tolerances. If the tolerances are really loose, there's always the possibility that this gets really close to the solder mask opening and then prints on the solder mask opening, or that it even prints on the pad itself. So it's best to just put it just a little bit away. Here, each of these grids is 5 mils. That's more than enough space. So you want to have, you know, a little over 5 mils between the edge of the silk screen and then this opening around the pad. So here, normally this is placed just as a solid. So the best way to do that is to set your width to basically double your radius. And so I've got a nice big dot here that indicates pin one. The other thing that you'll want to do is to indicate the outline of the component package. So to do that, you would want to copy these up to the top half. And just from looking at this, they're separated by, I'd have to do a little math. So you would just copy these pads that are down here in this row up to the top portion. And once you copy those over, you would want to draw out the component outline. So the component outline can be drawn just using lines. And you would want to just draw out a small line around this that indicates the edge of the component. You don't need to do it all the way across these pins. The issue is that, again, with any tolerances, there's always the risk that the solder mask opening in the pad runs into the silk screen. So I wouldn't want to necessarily put lines going across here. There's really no reason for it. The pads very nicely indicate the outline of the component. So what I would want to do is just use a line and start drawing this way. And then I would want to start drawing up to draw out the vertical edge of the component, and so on and so on. So you guys get the idea, and I'll leave this as an exercise for everyone else to complete once you do this in Circuit Maker. And then the last piece of information that you need is reference designator. So where are you going to put the reference designator? Typically in this type of component, you would want to put the reference designator so that it is oriented in the same way as the footprint. So I've actually done this rotated 90 degrees, which is not really the best way to do it. The way you would do this is to have the reference designator match this kind of orientation on the component. So this would be U, it's going to be U whatever. You can just leave it like this. And this would be in the silkscreen layer, and that's everything. Now, there's one last thing that we got to do with all this stuff. I'll go over here to properties. Notice here that I've drawn all of this mistakenly in the top layer. Now, this is really important because the top layer is a copper layer. All of the silkscreen that you want to draw is going to go into an overlay layer, either the top overlay or the bottom overlay. Now, since you're putting all your pads and stuff on the top layer, you want to put all of the silkscreen on top overlay. And so if you ever mess up, just go into your component properties and just select the object, select the layer, move it over to the top overlay. Pretty simple. Same thing here. I can just do this. And again, top overlay. For this object, top overlay, and then for the dot, top overlay. So that's one thing you can always check, and that's what's really nice about all of this being very conveniently color-coded, is that you can always tell when you mistakenly put something in a top copper layer versus a top overlay layer. So here, just make sure that if you have the top overlay layer selected, next thing that you go to draw, you'll see it already appears in the top overlay layer. So just be mindful of that, and if you make a mistake like I did, it's okay, it's easy to fix. So the next thing that I'd like to go over is what should you put in the PCB layout. Now, we've already handled a lot of the stuff that's going to go into the actual component. So what should you put in the PCB layout manually? Well, things like part numbers, company logos, any sort of operational instructions, maybe polarity indicators depending on the device, things like that should go into the PCB layout versus putting it into a component. I'll just give you an example here. So let's say I want to put a part number in. I'm going to open up Notepad. One thing you can do is just say, I'm going to call this PCB part number ABC123-01, and then I'll give it a revision. And one thing that's cool that CircuitMaker lets you do is I can just copy this text and paste it directly into the top overlay layer. Pretty cool, right? So typically you'll put the part number in like the lower right, somewhere where it's out of the way. Sometimes you have a really cramped board and you can't really do this. And so maybe you have to rotate it vertically and, or move it up, move it around somewhere where it's more convenient. Maybe you have to put it on the bottom overlay. It all depends on the device. Typically though, we just kind of put it in this lower right corner. And then you can do like a company logo as well. One thing that's cool about CircuitMaker is I can just go in here and like, you know, company ABC Incorporated. And we can make this a little stylish and fun. And I can even put like a line in here, and I can do this all in Paint. So I'll just save it. Okay, and most design software has some kind of graphic tool where you could just kind of insert this. Here, I'm just going to go into my graphic tool in CircuitMaker and open up my file, and there we are. Pretty cool, right? It's just going to open it up and automatically place it, and there it is. It's right there in the top overlay. Pretty simple. A lot of design software will make you use like a DXF file. DXF files are useful though for a lot of other things beyond just the company logo. So it's not that, you know, DXF files are necessarily bad. But this is a really quick and easy way to just import a company logo into the silkscreen layer in your PCB layout. So other things that might appear in here, you might have like assembly instructions or operational instructions, testing instructions, something like this. And you can use that to to basically tell someone who's using the board how it should operate, what they need to do to test it, how to power it up, whatever's necessary. So hopefully that gives you some perspective as far as what to put in the silkscreen layer and where it should probably be placed. And we'll do more layout tutorials like this, looking at how to use design software and what you should put in different layers and how to place components and all of that good stuff.
Okay, everybody, thanks for watching this demo. Hopefully that shows you how easy it is to add different pieces of information into your silkscreen layers in your components versus your PCB layout. Just remember that PCB design software doesn't generally call the silkscreen layer the silkscreen layer, it calls it an overlay layer. So this follows the same convention that's used in naming Gerber files. Okay, thanks for watching, everybody, and don't forget to call your fabricator.